Welcome back, everyone. In today's video, I want to show you a little bit about Photoshop Actions and how you can press a button and instantly transform your images quickly. This will work if you want to resize many images or even if you need to change a style to a photo fast. It is useful for artists and designers who take pictures and convert them into black and white images to resizing an image. If you have a couple, you can easily do this one at a time. But sometimes, if you have more than 1, 12, 20, or 50, a batch action would significantly speed the process up. So let's get started. The first thing I want to do is create a folder. I'm going to place this on my desktop to keep it simple. I'm going to name this folder 300 pixel because the size on the images will be 300 pixels wide. Let's open an image. I'm using an image from TMDB, a movie database where the images were downloaded and saved at 1280 pixels wide. I don't have my action panel open, so go under Window, Actions. Photoshop may have a folder called Default Action, and these come with your Photoshop application. As you can see, I no longer have it, but you can add a wooden frame if you truly want it. Okay, let's create our action. First thing first, we want to create a folder to hold this action. We should organize your actions. It does keep it nice and tidy. Besides the play button and plus icon is a folder. Click on that. A pop-up dialog box will open asking you to name your set. I will call this action set resized to 300 pixels. I will copy that for later because we also will need to name the action. Once that folder is created, we can now click on the plus sign to create a new action. I will paste the copy text resized to 300 pixels. Now be warned here, once we click the record, it will record everything you do in Photoshop. So it's always a good idea to write down your actions first so you know what you're doing. Okay, now I want to resize this image from 1280 pixels to 300 pixels. The keyboard shortcut is Command-Option-I for a Mac or Control-I for the PC or in the main menu, Image, Image Size. Because we want to resize our images smaller, I want to click Resample is checked on, which it is. This is Photoshop interpolation algorithm. It is telling how Photoshop handles throwing away pixels when you resample the image to a smaller size, and how it handles adding pixels when you resample the image to a larger size. Because we are making it smaller, we want to use sharper, and thankfully there is a hint that says reduction. If I click on the dropdown, you can see other algorithms if I resize it bigger. Okay, I also have the constraint proportion on too. See where the link is on? If it's broken, the size can be resized unproportionally. This isn't pleasant. So we need to make sure that this is turned on correctly. I'm going to change the width from 1280 to 300. Notice the size of the file from 7 megabytes to 394 kilobytes. Imagine your Photoshop file is so much smaller now. Click OK when ready. As you would notice, the action was recorded in the action panel. Next up, we want to save this file. Because I want my folders to be saved into a folder, I will save this action to a folder as well. Go to the menu, File, Save As. It's important to pick your image format. You will have a choice to select JPEG or PNG. I prefer the PNG format because it uses lossless compression, which maintains the original image quality without any loss. Click on Save. I will leave it as a default setting, which is the largest file size, and it is the PNG 24 file format, allowing for a wide range of colors and color depth compared to PNG 8. Click on OK. One more thing. Let's close the file. Click on the X of the image file or Command W on a Mac or Control W on a PC. Let's stop the recording. Besides the red circle on the left is a square. Go ahead and hit stop. And that's it. Let's test this out. It's always a good idea to test things. Let's open another image, select the action in the action panel, and click the play button. The image will either work or will give you an error message. So far, it looks good. Now, let's go back to the main menu, File, Automate, Batch. A dialog box will open with a setting. The cool thing, the last action used will be set up for you. In this case, play set and action. We need to choose a source of the image that we want to make a batch on. In this case, I have a folder called Movies TMDB. I have always had issues when I open a command, so if you notice, I already had the image open before I recorded my action. This is what I know, and theory issues are always the best for me. If you have images in subfolders, you can have this on. I don't. I do have suppressed color profile warnings on because the original images are from another source. and I do want to ignore these warnings. Next up is the destination. You can change the destination, of course, but because I'm saving this into a folder already that I made, I will keep what I have set up. I did not have the override action save as commands check, only because it worked fine as is. If it doesn't for you, then you can always go back and check it. I didn't bother. I do want to keep the same names in my files, so I have it all set up. If you want to have a different name, then you need to have a different setup here. You would need to add a document name and a serial number for it to work, or else an error message will open then. The following is what I would use for setting up a different name than the original files. But in this case, I do want them same movie names on the resized images. I did turn on Windows compatibility. I am on a Mac, so mine was already selected, and maybe your setting will be different on your PC, and you need to select a Mac OS. Please let me know if it is in the comments. When ready, click on OK. As you can see, Photoshop will do its thing. If you have a lot of images, you can step back in a couple of minutes. I know the 15 images that I have, it will be done in 10 seconds or less. Let's confirm. I will do a get info, and you can see the image is now 300 pixels wide. And there you have it, your very own quick action that speeds your process up. If you have any questions, leave us a comment below. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell so you'll be the next to know when our next video is. Thanks for watching.